weekend, many toy makers are crossing their fingers, hoping they'll have the next Tickle Me Elmo on their hands. Lisa Frank's products are already must-have items for many young schoolgirls. Tony Guida tells us how the Arizona company captures its customers' hearts and their parents' money.
You are looking at the future of retail, and it can barely see over the counter. She may not always have complete control of her things or hold them in the most traditional fashion, but do not underestimate the buying power of a little girl.
Last year, they spent $15 billion of their own money, and they're spending and influencing another $165 from their parents.
Staggering figures, particularly if you are the Tucson, Arizona-based Lisa Frank Company. It pulls in $250 million a year, catering exclusively to the whims of 4 to 12-year-old girls.
We've been marketing to them, actually exclusively, all of our life.
They market everything from feather boa plastic purses to brightly colored school supplies, stationery, activity sets, you name it. If a little girl uses it, chances are Lisa Frank makes it.
I love Lisa Frank products.
And I love the colors, and it's colorful, and not everything's like everything's up just black.
I just love it.
They love the Lisa Frank line so much, there's even a Lisa Frank fan club and the Lisa Frank website, the envy of many a web marketeer.
We get 60,000 hits a day. That kind of equates to like a million hits a month.
20 years ago, two struggling artists, Lisa Frank and James Green, joined forces and started a sticker company. They sold their colorful concoctions to small stores all across the United States. But just when they were on the verge of striking it rich, the popular sticker market came unglued.
We had like millions of, you know, units of stickers. And when the bottom falls out of the industry, what are you going to do with all the goods? So we started packaging the stuff for mass market.
They also expanded their line. From stickers, they moved into school supplies. Just like Starbucks turned a simple cup of coffee into a $4 a cup brand, Lisa Frank figured out how to charge four times the going rate by turning basic pencils and notebooks into must-have items for school kids. Sales of her splashy colored goods took off at mass market outlets.
It's almost as if they had radar and were able to go into the minds of these young girls, because they were really able to see exactly what these young girls are interested in and what they would buy.
Frank and Green, who are also husband and wife, say that radar comes from the marriage of their minds and their distinct personalities. Frank sticks to creating new product.
She understands consumers. She understands little girls. You know, she's a little girl at heart. I mean, she's very in tune. You know, she's probably the world's greatest shopper.
A lot comes from going to the zoo or just, you know, art museums, reading magazines from everywhere. The kids maybe give you an idea.
Green handles everything else. On any given day, he can be found anywhere in the headquarters, sketching here, projecting earnings there, overseeing artists or the production crew.
I spend a lot of time focused on the business. I know where my priorities lay.
Top priority for both Green and Frank, to keep little girls coming back for more, so they don't make a move without first consulting their finicky audience.
Good morning, class.
Good morning.
Well, thank you. My name is Carol, and I'm here today from Lisa Frank.
Lisa Frank product testers can be found a day or two a week in any of Tucson's elementary schools. Whole classes are recruited as focus groups for upcoming projects.
I just was testing fabric swatches with the middle school and elementary, and I had 16 boards at one time, and we had them pick out. We were completely surprised, the ones they picked out, because we would not even have picked them.
While kids kill stuff before it ever gets off the ground, Green and Frank weigh in too, scotching items for the tiniest of perceived flaws.
We're very fanatical. I mean, you should look in our reject pile. I mean, our reject pile, people think are good goods. I mean, even sometimes I get confused. I mean, those look pretty good. What's wrong with them?
Such scrutiny has meant few recent missteps.
At this point, we don't have too many dogs because, oh boy, when you get a dog, you get a dog. But we don't have too many because I'm much more focused and, you know, calculated about what we come out with, because it's like, you know, in the early days, we just came out with, it was kind of like you come out with 20 things and hope 5 sell. Today, you can't afford to do that. If you come out with 20 things, you better hope 19 sell, you know, because no one remembers your successes. Everybody remembers your dogs.
Retail experts are hard-pressed to remember any dogs, though. As the company continues to expand its lines, licensing, putting its brand name on everything from Little Girl sneakers to CD-ROMs, they see only blue skies ahead. So color the Lisa Frank world happy, for it has figured out a way to use reds and blues on yellow pencils to create lots of green for the company. For Business Unusual, Tony Guida, CNN Financial News.